Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Deepa Soman, and these are the major news stories of Friday, October 4th, 2024. In a rare Friday sermon, Iran's Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei said Israel won't last long and backed the Palestinian and Lebanese movements against the Jewish state. This was his first public address in 5 years. Supreme Court has ordered an independent probe by a special investigation team into the Tirupati Laddu controversy. The CBI director will supervise the probe. The centre has opposed criminalization of marital rape before the apex court, claiming it may lead to serious disturbances in the institution of marriage. The alleged assault on youth Congress activists by Kerala CM's gunman and cops was a mistake of fact, according to the police's final report. Supreme Court has dismissed review petitions against its decision, holding that subclassification of scheduled castes is permissible to grant separate quotas for more backwards within the scheduled caste categories. Let's get into the details. Iran's Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei said Israel won't last long as he backed the Palestinian and Lebanese movements against the country in his rare Friday sermon. Addressing thousands of supporters at a mosque in Tehran, he justified Iran's missile strikes on Israel as a public service. He also declared that Israel would not prevail against Hamas or Hezbollah as chants of "We are with you" from the crowd echoed in the vast mosque grounds. His first sermon in 5 years marked a crucial show of defiance amid threats to the Supreme Leader's life. The Supreme Court on Friday ordered an independent probe by a special investigation team into the alleged use of animal fat in making Tirupati Laddus. The team will comprise two officials each from the Central Bureau of Investigation and the State Police Force and a senior personnel from the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, reported PTI. The CBI director will supervise the probe. The bench, including Justices B.R. Gawai and K.V. Vishwanathan, also observed that it does not want political drama over the controversy since it is a matter of faith for millions of devotees. If sexual acts by a man with his own wife is made punishable as rape, it may severely impact the conjugal relationship and lead to serious disturbances in the institution of marriage, the centre has told the Supreme Court. Opposing the criminalization of marital rape, which is sought by many petitioners before the apex court, the centre has filed its preliminary counter-affidavit in the top court. The apex court is seized of petitions raising the vexed legal question of whether a husband should enjoy immunity from prosecution for the offence of rape if he forces his wife, who is not a minor, to have sex. Under the exception clause of Section 375 of the Indian Penal Code, now repealed and replaced by the Bharati Nyay Sanhita, sexual intercourse or sexual acts by a man with his wife, the wife not being a minor, is not rape. Even under the new law, Exception 2 to Section 63 on rape says that sexual intercourse or sexual acts by a man with his own wife, the wife not being under 18 years of age, is not rape. The alleged assault on youth Congress activists by Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan's gunman and cops in Alappuzha when the CM and ministers were travelling as part of Nav Kerala Sadas was a mistake of fact, according to the refer report submitted by police with the Judicial First Class Magistrate Court 1, Alappuzha. The police have also labelled the type of final report as unoccurred. Once an FIR is registered in a case, police collect evidence and statements and file a final report, which is treated as a charge sheet. In this case, police submitted a report saying that the accusations were factually wrong and that the incident never happened. The case is scheduled for hearing on October 17th. The Supreme Court has dismissed the review petitions against its decision, holding that subclassification of scheduled castes is permissible to grant separate quotas for more backwards within the scheduled caste categories. On August 1st, a 7-judge constitution bench of the Supreme Court by 6-1 majority held that states can identify more backwards among the scheduled caste categories and can subclassify them for giving separate quotas within the quota. Following that, several review petitions were filed against the judgment. The court refused to review the judgment, stating that there was no error apparent on the face of it. Having perused the review petitions, there is no error apparent on the face of the record. No case for review under Order 47, Rule 1 of the Supreme Court Rules 2013 has been established. The review petitions are, therefore, dismissed, stated the order passed by the bench in chambers. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Deepa Soman, and produced by Vishnu Muralidharan. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.